ومن يقنت منكن لله ورسوله وتعمل صالحا نؤتها أجرها مرتين وأعتدنا لها رزقا كريما
ومن يقنت منكن لله ورسوله وتعمل صالحا نؤتها أجرها مرتين وأعتدنا لها رزقا كريما.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. All praise be to Allah Almighty, and peace be upon His beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I testify that there is no God except Allah, and I testify that Muhammad is the Prophet and the Messenger of Allah. Dear viewers, with a new series on Huda TV, Pioneer Women in Islam, these great women that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had mentioned in the Quran Kareem, that our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stated in his hadiths, and these great women that we are proud that are part of our Islamic history to look up to and take them as an example. When I say pioneer and great women in Islam, I don't mean that these great women that we'll be talking about are just an example to the women and the females of this ummah. But by Allah, they are a great example to the entire ummah, men before the women. They're an example for every single human being to the day of judgment. These great women, that inshallah will be with you and talking about them in this series, the pioneer women in Islam, they are a great example and an example to the entire mankind, for the men before the women, and for our women, for our females. As regularly, females always say that we're only here of men, and we're only here great companions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, prophets and messengers who are just men, and we always hear about great scholars and imams who are just men. But our Islamic history is also full of great women, full of great females that we look up to and take as an example. And they are an example for every single female and every single Muslimah that want to take her as an example. And amongst those great examples that we will be talking about today, inshaAllah, is that great woman that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had mentioned here in the Quran Kareem in more than one place. And Allah Almighty had even named one full surah after her name as an honor to her and to her child, Isa alayhi salam. And this great woman is Maryam alayhi salam. Maryam, the daughter of Imran. Maryam is that great woman that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had mentioned in the Quran Kareem. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala once again named a full surah after her. And Allah Almighty mentioned her in different places, in different verses, in different surah in the Quran. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam frequently mentioned her in his hadith. And he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, كَمُلَ مِنَ الرِّجَالِ كَثِيرٌ وَلَمْ يَكْمُلْ مِنَ النِّسَاءِ إِلَّا مَرْيَمْ بِنْتُ عُمْرَانْ and Khadija بِنْتُ خُوَيْلِدْ and Asia بِنْتُ Asia زوجة فرعون وفاطمة بنت محمد sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam states in this hadith that many men became perfect and complete. And when he says many men became perfect and complete, he refers to the prophets and the messengers and their disciples and many of the great companions. Then he says sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and not many women became complete and perfect. And then the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam makes an exception. And he says, except Maryam. Maryam, the daughter of Imran. And Khadija, the daughter of Khuwaylid. And Fatima, the daughter of Muhammad. And Asiya, the wife of Fir'aun and the daughter of Muzahim. And inshallah, we'll be talking about those great four pioneer women. But we start with Maryam. Maryam, the daughter of Imran, the mother of Isa alayhi salam. This great woman that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran Kareem and spoke about her story in the Holy Quran in details, that you don't find many prophets and messengers or many great people in Islam in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the story in details the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the story of Maryam. And obviously when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about someone in the Qur'an al-Kareem or mentions a story of someone in the Qur'an al-Kareem, obviously there is a great message. There's an important message and a lesson for people to learn. Those who read the Qur'an al-Kareem, those who recite the Qur'an al-Kareem, and those who believe in the Qur'an al-Kareem. There are many stories and lessons for us to learn. When we hear those stories, and the ibrah, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Qur'an, there are lessons for those who want to learn. There are lessons for those who want to know. There are lessons for those who want to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that lesson of Maryam, the daughter of Imran, it begins from her mother, Hannah. Hannah is the mother of Maryam, who was the wife of the pious and righteous man, Imran. Hannah was a righteous and a pious female, like her husband, like her daughter. And one day, Hannah, after many years of wanting a child, to fall pregnant and to have this child that can be a mean and a cause to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with, Hannah was wanting and waiting for this moment that she falls pregnant and have this child to be under the service of Islam and under the service of Bayt al-Maqdis. So one day, while Hannah was traveling somewhere, she sees a mother bird feeding its children, feeding its little birds. So when she saw this amazing miracle of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala within His creation, when she saw this amazing miracle that a mother bird feeds its children, feeds its baby children that's in need of food, the mercy that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had bestowed within this animal, she was amazed. And then she started to wish for that child. She started to wish to have this child that she could get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through that child. So she said in her heart, and she made this vow to Allah, Rabbi, inni nadartu laka ma fi batni muharraran, fataqabbal minni, innaka anta sami'u al-alim. Oh Allah, I had made a vow and a promise that whatever I carry within my womb, this child will be under your service. This child will be a child that I'll do the best and work and do the most utmost best to make this child to be a righteous child. And she made that vow that if she gets this child, especially if it's a male child, if it's a boy, that this child will be in the service of Bayt al-Maqdis, will be in the service of the sacred place of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Jerusalem. And for that child to be someone that will serve the house of Allah, will serve the scholars of Islam, and also become someone who will learn Islam and teach others of Islam. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted his supplication and dua from this sincere woman. And Allah Azza wa Jal made Hannah fall pregnant, even though she was an old woman. And it was that moment that Hannah felt the pregnancy in her womb. And her husband Imran, her husband, that righteous man, who was considered to be also the head and the master of the scholars of Bani Israel during that time, he was so happy, but he did not live long enough to see that righteous child to be born. And Hannah falls pregnant, and Hannah gives birth to this righteous female. But Hannah was amazed to see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave her a male baby boy, a male child. Can we cut this one? Okay. Continue from the last one. Yeah. I got mixed up. No. So, Maryam. So, Hannah was amazed to see that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed her with this beautiful child, it was a female child. And she was expecting a male child. A male child that can grow up in Bayt al-Maqdis under the service of the scholars of Bayt al-Maqdis and serve Bayt al-Maqdis and serve the scholars of Bani Israel. But it was that moment that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted that she carried a female child, and that female child was later on was to be named Maryam. فَلَمَّا وَضَعَتْهَا قَالَتْ رَبِّ إِنِّي وَضَعْتُهَا أُنْثَى والله أعلم بما وضعت وليس الذكر كالأنثى. When she gave birth, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, she gave birth to a female baby. She gave birth to a female child. So she said, oh Allah, I gave birth to a female child. And I had made this vow and promise that if I get this child, I'm going to make this child under your service, in your sacred place. وَلَيْسَ الذَّكَرُ كَالْأُنْثَى. And a male child is not like a female child. Not when it comes to discrimination or comparison to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah azza wa jalla says, إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ. That the most honorable and respectful one to Allah is the one that fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala most. But when Maryam said that the male child is not like the female child, that's when it comes to the service of Bayt al-Maqdis. That at that time it was only male children were to be accepted to be under the service or to be accepted to serve Bayt al-Maqdis. But female child was not a customary thing to be sent to Bayt al-Maqdis. And then she said, وَإِنِّي سَمَّيْتُهَا مَرْيَمْ وَإِنِّي أُعِيذُهَا بِكَ وَذُرِّيَّتَهَا مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ. And oh my Lord, I had named her Maryam. I had named her Maryam. And I ask you to protect her from the path of the shaitan and the outcast shaitan. And the word Maryam, and the word Maryam, according to the people of Israel, means pure, a pure virgin, a pure virgin female. And that's why she named her Maryam, a pure child that's there for the sake of Allah and the service of the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the service of Islam. More on Maryam and what happens after this child was born and this child grew up, and more on the story of Maryam, inshallah, be with us in the next episode, part 2, on Maryam alayha salam, the daughter of Imran, the mother of Isa alayhi salam. And inshallah, we look forward to you be with us in the next episode. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
ومن يقنت منكن لله ورسوله وتعمل صالحا نؤتها أجرها مرتين وأعتدنا لها رزقا كريما.
ومن يقنت منكن لله ورسوله وتعمل صالحا نؤتها أجرها مرتين وأعتدنا لها رزقا كريما.
كن لله ورسوله وتعمل صالحا نؤتها أجرها مرتين وأعتدنا لها رزقا كريما.